Welcome to The Gist, the show that brings you what's trending right now. My special guest today is one of my favorite Afropop artists. He's given us great songs such as Boom Boom Ta, Number One, Now What's Up, and Green Light. It is Mista Silva.
I am leaving with you, leaving with you, leaving with you. Get down on me.
Give me the green light. The green light, green light.
Hey.
How are you doing? Are you alright?
I'm good, thank you. Can I just say, we've been talking for a little bit, but you are my favorite UK Afropop artist. I mean, there are others, but then you are the best right now on my list. So, what's behind Mista Silva? Why did you choose that name?
First of all, it's going to big you up, get me, for showing the love towards my music, and you know, I appreciate that a lot. My name, Mista Silva, it comes from like a long time ago, let's say about 2008, a couple of me and my friends, like, we formed an entertainment group called Fresh As If Entertainments.
Okay.
And when we was forming this group, yeah, the intentions was to basically do events and promote our music at the same time, like basically drawing a crowd.
Yeah.
So that we can expose them to our type of music that we are doing. And yeah, and we thought to ourselves, okay, let's put some names like to ourselves as well as that. And obviously we had an older brother or cousin, I should say, or family friend who was into the scene already, like doing events and promotions and stuff, and he goes by the name of Mikel Silva. So from there we was like, you know what, we're gonna take the Silva name and everybody just put Silva at the end of your name. But then obviously where I'm an artist as well, I was like, you know what, I just don't want to put Silva on the name. It has to mean something to me.
Yeah.
Because I'm an artist as well as what we're doing. So I took that from it and then I added to it strong, inspirational, lively, versatile artist. So that's what Silva stands for. So that's where it came from, really and truly.
Nice. I'm liking that. So you've been in the scene since about 2012. But then we don't really know much about you. Have you always been in music, or is it something that you just stepped into?
I've been doing music for a while, you know. I'd say, yeah, 2011, 2012 was when I really stepped into the Afrobeats, Afropop kind of genre, like really like that. But I was doing my thing way before, like I said, from like 2008, those times there, I was doing funky house music. So yeah, I used to go around like hosting sets with DJ Pioneer, Marcus Nasty, all the big house DJs you hear out there. I used to be on their sets. And yeah, man, we used to do a madness. And that's what really got my name out there. Yeah, and from there, let's say around 2011, 2012, that's when people's like, okay, the way you do your music is really Afrocentric, like you got some Afro feel about it, but you also got this UK appeal about your music, so you know what, you should jump on some Afro beats and that. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. At first I was like, okay, cool, you know what, let me go back to my roots and see what happens. And yeah, that's what Thornborn sent my me. Yeah, and from there Boom Boom Ta came, and then the rest started flowing, and I felt like this is where I need to be in the place of music. I feel like this is me. Like, I'm mixing and blending the two cultures together.
Yeah.
And creating a whole different kind of feel to the music. So, yeah, man.
Did you release any, like, funky music before?
Yeah, man, I had some great hits, actually, in the funky house scene. I had a track called If You're On This, Let Me Know. I had a track called 10 Out of 10. I had quite a few tracks, Skanking King. I had quite a few tracks out there. Had very popular lyrics, which used to... Like, I used to go to the parties and raves and spit at the raves. And yeah, people would know, if you're familiar with me, you know I had a lyric that would go like this: we ain't playing around, mixing a blend with the heavyweight sounder, sounds of the silver, sexy ladies go down to the ground. And that was one of like the popular bars which was out there. So yeah, man, I've had like quite a few bars in the funky house scene.
Nice. So where can we get hold of that, because I would love to hear it?
They're out there, you know. I don't even know, like, go to YouTube, SoundCloud, type in like couple like sets with DJs, like DJ Clipper. If you type in his thing, you'll see that I did a lot of stuff with him. Pioneer, Chosen Ones, there's quite a few, you know. Cameo, even 10 out of 10, all those stuff are still available on YouTube. So if you look them up, you'll find them.
Great. So your music always gets like people into the right vibe, whether it's partying or just chilling at home. Like your vocals and your lyrics is on point, but then your production, like what producers do you use? Are they London based or based in Ghana?
I've been working with a few producers, really and truly. Yeah. I've got some in London and there's some in Ghana as well. I'm working with a guy called Mixmaster Ghazi, 2MG Entertainment in Ghana. Mm-hmm. So yeah, we've made an interlink from there. He's the one who produced Boom Boom Ta. He produced Now What's Up. I work with a guy called Bolts Made It. He's the one who just produced my latest one out called Like It. There's various producers enter the A.M.E. I'm a person that likes to work with different producers. I don't like to stick with one person because you don't know what sound you're going to create with another producer. You don't know what kind of magic you're going to make with them, innit? So I always try and work with different producers and interlink what I'm doing with them.
Are you working on an album right now?
Let's say Full Vim came out like a couple years back, so that was like really the first kind of like UK Afrobeats EP to come from any UK Afrobeat artists and stuff. So yeah, that was then. I'm currently working on actually a new EP. I'm not actually jumping into my album yet. I'm waiting for the right moment. I don't feel to myself that it's the right moment to drop an album, even though other people might be like, yo, Silva, drop an album. We think, me personally, I feel like I need to be in a certain place or a certain level before I drop that album so that it can get out to more people. So I'll be working on, I'm working on another EP, which will be coming out soon. Like I said, the lead single, Like It, came out. We're working on a video scene for that. Soon there'll be another track coming up called B.A.D, which stands for Best Achieving Done. So okay. So we're working on it, man. We're working on it. And there's a few stuff. There's a few singles which have been out, like Kutusa, Green Light. All those things there have been circulating around, doing their thing. Yeah. But yeah, man, we're just getting all the pieces of the puzzle right. And then, boom, we're going to let it off, man. And it's, the EP's called Let It Off. So, yeah.
Okay, I like the sound of that.
Yeah, man.
You mentioned Green Light. Yeah. I mean, Green Light sounds different from the other stuff that you've done. It has more of a EDM sort of feel to it. Mm-hmm. So what producer did you work with and did he play you the track and you thought, okay, I want to jump on that, or was it the sort of like vision you had for it?
Know what, that one came around by a producer called JF Media, and these guys, they had my track Now What's Up on that radio and the playlisting and stuff, and then they got at me like, yo, we love what you're doing. We think that dance music and Afro pop and Afro beats has a close link to each other. So, like, why not come together and see what we can do? And I was like, you know what? I'm a person that's versatile. Is in my name. Mm-hmm. I've come from Funky House. I've done grime. I'm doing Afro beats now, Afro pop. Mm-hmm. Why not make a venture into the other market there as well and try and reach out to that clientele who's there to get to for them to know that there's a sound called Afrobeats and a sound called Afropop. Yeah. That, you know, so I just thought, yeah, let me do it and see what happens. And when I did do it, it opened another doors for me, opened the record deal, opened the Polydor signing and stuff like that. So yeah, and that's able Polydor, those labels to see, that's a major label to see that there is a genre out there called Afrobeats, there is a genre out there called Afropop, you know what I'm saying? And that's what it's done for me. It's been doing great things for me, and I think, yeah, it's done great things. It's been on Tawi, you know, it's been on circulating on TV, on a couple other shows as well, on like Viva and MTV Base. It hit the top 20 on there as well. So, you know, it's been a great venture for myself, and yeah, man, it's just an experiment to see where things will go. And yeah, it's done great things, you know, so big up the people who's all supported that, you know. It's been fantastic.
It was the perfect song for the summer. I mean, I was not in one of the hot holiday destinations, but at home, it brought that Ibiza feel to my house, definitely. So how's it been signing to Polydor? How's that working out so far?
So far, it's okay. So far, it's okay. You know, we're working. Everything in this world these days is numbers, you know. So you have to just continue what you're doing, really, true. If you believe in what you're doing, eventually you'll get what you need to do and you'll get where you want to get to. So it's been a good thing. I won't lie. It's been good, you know. But obviously, it's also a challenge at the same time, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's a challenge, definitely. So, yeah.
Because you're more of an Afropop artist, so you have to compromise with their aims and their targets.
Exactly that. Okay. I'll definitely say, yeah, it's a compromise for them as well.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So we're in a good place. So just keep working and continue to do what we're doing and see what God will do, man.
Yeah. That's good. You're one of the main artists in the UK Afropop scene. Yeah. So what do you think the future of the Afropop scene sort of like holds?
It holds great things. It holds great things, to be honest. Infused is probably the only urban artist in the UK who is charting, like, properly. If you look at a UK rap lot, okay, cool, but no one's really charted as much as what Fuse has charted this year, you know what I'm saying? So they need to look at that and think, okay, cool, what's going on here? What's the trend here? And say, look, we need to start listening to what these guys are doing, because there's a lot of us that's out here that's doing a lot on the underground circuit, you know what I'm saying? So they need to look at it. So I'll big up Fuse's label, man, because they're doing great things for him and making him excel where he needs to get to. And other labels which have got artists like Mo Logo, who's on Island Records, think that the scene is going to grow. I think that the scene's going to keep going forward, and it has been going forward because it's been going for about 4 years, 5 years in terms of the UK aspect of things. And people didn't think that it would last that long, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's still here, it's still going strong. There's a lot of unity within the scene. I just come off Fuse OGD's tour as well with him. We went around, where did we go? Went to Birmingham, Manchester, and two nights in London. And the crowd was full of young kids who's enjoying Afrobeats, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And it just shows that this is a multi-general. It's not just for us, it's for everybody. And yeah, it's great love, man. It's great love. And then you've got guys like my brothers, Quantum and Flavor, they just dropped their EP, they are. So they're doing their thing. You got Sonner Man, who's doing his thing. There's a lot of us who's talented in this scene. It's got a strong basis. You just need a lot of people to come in and start investing in the right places. And boom, it's a crazy thing.
Yeah, nice.
All eyes on me, I'm a S.T.A., a underground G. I bring out the vibe inside the party. Bring out the glasses, sit the dumb tea. From my head to my toe, it's every duty. Attention, that's what you want from me. But my head's in a state, I'm so wavy. I'm murking the dance, it's full crazy. Hands in the air, get it all with me. So I walk to the crowd, to the young lady.
So how do you challenge yourself creatively?
To challenge myself, just all the time, like, trying to make bangers, to be honest, and just trying to do me, to be honest, and trying to just achieve what I want to achieve. If I feel like I haven't achieved where I really want to get to, then that always keeps me going and keeps me motivated to make more, because it's like, okay, I've done that one, mate, okay, it's not enough then. It seems like it's not enough. More needs to come. It's not enough. More needs to come. And I don't think I'll be pleased. I'm one of them people who just always wants more, like, once I get something, that's it. I want to go even further. So yeah, man, that's what keeps me, my inner drive and yeah, my belief in myself and my talent. That's what keeps me moving, man.
Okay, that's good. So what other art forms do you like draw influences from, or what did you used to listen to when you were growing up that sort of resonates now in your music?
I'd say when I was growing up, I was listening to a lot of like garage and grime mixed with high life and hip-hop, man. That's what I'd say. Like, in my household, my older brothers are into music as well, so my older brothers would bring home garage music and stuff, and that's what was popping off, like, when I was little. So like Soul Solid Crew, all those lot there, Your Sweet Like Chocolate, all those kind of things there, I was listening to. Then my dad would be pumping like the hip life and the high life music, so like the Castros, the Dandy Lumbers, and all the things. Yeah, definitely around the house, and then going to parties and they play that music. Oh, you find me in the middle of the dance floor dancing, everybody's looking at me like yeah. And then obviously Michael Jackson, of course, people like Jay-Z, you know, these people there, they inspire me, man, because they've come a long way, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it just reminds me of like my journey, and that like Jay-Z didn't get to where he got to in one day. He didn't build it in one day. Rome wasn't built in a day, you know what I'm saying? So that's what keeps me going, man. And that's the influences creatively that I look at. You know, I'm always trying to look at these artists and think to myself, okay, cool, yeah, man. It's there, man, if you've got the talent. Cool.
So what do you think sets you apart from all the other artists? I know you mentioned Sonner, Malogo, Fuse. You guys are all big right now in the scene in the UK, and you're all quite different with your sounds.
Definitely. I think my sound is very, like, vibrant. You know what I mean? It's got a lot of energy in it.
A lot.
A lot of energy in it, my sound. I'd say also me, I'm not just a singer, I'm a rapper as well. So I can rap, I can sing. So that adds two difference to it as well. And I've got a lot of UK influence in my music as well, I'd say. So yeah, that's what would set me out. And I'm very tall. I stand up.
Yeah, you definitely can't miss you. So you were one of the driving force behind Azonto in 2012 and obviously currently now as well. Have you traveled to Ghana to perform, or how's your music received over in Ghana?
My music is received lovely. Like, people know who I am out there. They know my music, they play it, you know what I'm saying? I go out there almost like for the past 2 years. I've been going there like every December and been doing my thing over there. I performed at Ghana Independence Square. I performed at the National Theatre, at the Dome, all the big venues in Ghana, in the main city, Accra. I performed there. So it's been a great feeling to go back home and be received by those that are there. Me being born here in the UK, and I'm going there and showing them, look, Charlie, me, I'm born here, Charlie, but, you know, I'm coming back home to show you that, yo, I'm pushing Africa, I'm pushing Ghana in the UK and Europe, and just trying to move it forward for everybody to enjoy the culture and the music that we're bringing, man. So, yeah, man, just interlinking the two, like I said, the two cultures, merging it and doing the madness with it.
I would actually like to hear you on a track with maybe like R2B or Sakodia, maybe Kwabana and Samini. Like, have you got any collaborations coming up with one of those artists or any other artists from Ghana?
To be honest, I'm good friends with R2Bs. We worked on something last year when the time is right. I know them, so we'll get that, we'll get done, you know what I'm saying, at the right point and the right time. There's a track there with me and Muggies, but I just need to just get things in line to how I want it to be, and then I release that track there. Sarkodie, I know of him, he knows of me as well, so when we see each other, it's like, yeah, mutual respect and stuff like that. Yeah, definitely I want to work with these people, you know what I'm saying. So when the time is right and when they're ready, me, I'm ready. So when they're ready, and they can, we can link up and make it happen.
So you spoke earlier about your EP that's coming out in a bit. Is it just going to be more like the themes and the topics? Is it going to be about dance and girls and love? Are we going to have more political stuff coming through, or your biography? Or
It'll be a mixture, you know. It'll be a mixture of, there'll be some dance vibe tracks in there. There'll be some, like, tracks that just coming from the heart, like just expressing how I feel about myself and how I feel about the genre and my style and whatnot. There'll be tracks in there where I'm giving praise to God. That's a mixture, you know. I like to just give a mixture of sounds and a mixture of vibes within the EP. So yeah, it's a body of music, so you don't want to just have one one thing in there. So you want stuff for everybody, that can everybody can appeal to. So yeah, it's going to be a mixture of stuff, really and truly. So yeah, that's what it's going
to
be like.
That's great. I'm excited about that, because all of your songs that I listen to just gets me in that mood to start doing the Azonto moves. But yeah, so I know one Ghanaian slang, which is more vim. I like that. I don't know what it is, but when you said, I feel like I kind of understand what it is. What does it mean?
More of like vim is like your courage within, like your drive within, like had to have that power within yourself to achieve more things, like to do better. I'm saying it's like, come on, go on, do your thing. So that's what it means, basically.
I'm gonna be using that often now. So teach me a couple of more like Ghanaian slangs.
You got more vim. My own personal one I've been using lately is spode.
What does that mean?
It's like, I'm going to shut down. Like, I'm going to shut down the place, like, spoil there. So, yeah, that's my personal one I've been using lately. That's it. You know, that's another one. Like, yeah, that's good. So there's a few.
Might throw it in when I'm speaking to people. Just be like, I'm cool. So I just want to say congratulations on your nominees this year for some of the award shows. I mean, you were nominated for BAFTA, the Mobos. I mean, so far in the Mobos category for Afropop, it's mainly been the international acts, and you were on there. So how was that?
It was a great feeling to be nominated, you know. You know what I'm saying? I've been doing my thing from, like you said, 2012, 2011. having the first Afrobeats UK track to be playlisted on national radio and those things there. It was a great feeling, man. I felt like, yeah, man, they're appreciating what I'm doing, but it would have been greater to win it, you know what I'm saying? But like, God knows what the future holds, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's another stepping stone for me. It keeps me motivated, it keeps me going. It shows me that they appreciate what I'm doing. So
yeah.
I'm grateful to have these nominations against my name each and every year. Since I've been doing Afrobeats, I've been getting nominated. First year was like GMAs and Guba, which I won for Best UK Afrobeats Artist and Best Emerging Act in 2013. I got UMA nomination and other nominations. This year again, UMAs, Mobos and BAFTA. So we'll see what happens, man. I'm just going to keep doing what I'm doing.
So I know when artists are all in the award show, you've got different artists from different genres that you probably don't even get to speak to. So it's almost like a networking event. Mm-hmm. So who from the UK scene that is not Afropop that you might have a collaboration coming with?
We're looking into stuff, you know. Stormzy got in contact with me. We're good friends. So he's doing his thing right now. He picked up Best Grime UK Act. So we're looking at possibly getting something done with him. There's African Boy who was there as well. I'm looking at Feki as well.
Nice.
You know what I'm saying? So there's potential. 100%. 100%. You know what I'm saying? So there's things that could happen. You know what I'm saying? So it's, they know I'm there. I know them. So just getting it and making it happen, man. So we'll see what happens, man. It was great to network that day, man. That's what I really liked about going to the Mobos this year. Like, I was able to just meet all these people and network and, yeah, man, just get the links up. You know what I mean?
What about the female acts such as, like, Lil Sims, Paige Keke and Lee Shard?
I've met Lil Sims before.
Yeah.
We did a feature for Trendset UK. And she was in there as well. So, yeah, and I got in contact with her management. He's interested in making something happen. So I'm going to get at them, you know, and actually see what we can do. I even might get her on BAD.
Okay.
That's the next single after Like It. Like I said, Best Achieving Done. So she's a done.
Definitely.
So why not? So definitely. I'm probably going to get in contact with her and see what she's saying, how she feels about making it happen. That would be good to get some UK hip hop act with an Afrobeat act. And just, yeah, man, see where it goes from there.
We've been speaking and I really love your passion for what you're doing and for music and obviously the fusion of the different sounds that you like.
Yeah.
So what would you say, what would you be doing if you weren't a singer? Did you have a plan B? Because I can't see you doing anything else.
Boy, if it was at music, it would have been football, to be honest. And obviously I've been to uni. I went to De Montfort University where I studied business information technology. But my passion lies in music.
Okay, that's nice. Speaking of platforms, you walked the catwalk. Mm-hmm. Was it this year?
Last year.
Yes,
yeah, I was there.
You were there.
A couple of times. I went down to a couple of shows and stuff. And yeah, but last year I was on London Fashion Week walking for Ashish. Yeah, man, just getting my foot in the fashion game as well.
How did that collaboration with Ashish come about? Because the brand has been featured in Vogue, so it's a big brand.
Yeah, definitely. It's a very big brand. It was through a modeling agency that I'm listed on. Okay. And they got in contact with me and they was like, yo, we feel that you fit the what we're looking for, come down. The comfort screening went down. Ashish was there. He's like, yeah, man, feeling you. I'm going to use you to my catwalk. So yeah, man, and I think I was like one of the first males to ever walk for him, you know what I'm saying, because he's was first on like woman's range and now he's looking into men's range. So I was like one of the first to do that, and yeah, it was a great experience to walk on the catwalk, man, and just see that kind of community. Everybody's got their communities and like where they socialize and what they do. It's a whole different scene, you know what I'm saying. And
it'll be interesting to see you perform at a fashion show. That'll be really cool.
Trust, definitely, it'll be very great to see that happen. It'll be very, very great. But yeah, man, like I said, we're working towards things, man. So we'll see what God does for us, man. And I'm just gonna keep grinding.
So now that you're doing music, you've done fashion, and you're gonna keep doing fashion, are we gonna see you in acting?
Yeah, man. Why not? I've got many talents.
Yeah.
I've got many talents in me. You know what I'm saying? This is just the icing. You know what I'm saying? To get inside the filling, which I haven't even exposed yet. So this is the icing on the cake. And yeah, man, definitely would love to get into some acting and all those things there. But everything's step by step, man.
Step by step.
So yeah.
You featured on Afrobeat's song in 2013, My Sweet Coco. I love that song. It's an amazing song. It just has that really nice R&B bedroom vibe. So, how would you approach a lady? This is for the ladies out there. Or the females crushing on Mr. Silva, okay? I've got you. How do you approach them?
To be honest, you know what I'm saying? If I see somebody who I like, I'll probably give you the eye first. You know what I'm saying? Just give you a couple hints and that. And then, to be honest, if I like it, I'm going to come speak to you and get to know you. So just keep it real and keep it 100. I think women like people who keep it real, you know, and just keep it up front, to be honest. There's no point in beating around the bush. And that's the kind of person I am. Like, I keep it up front. If I'm interested, I'm going to come and I'm going to talk to you. I'm going to get to know you. I'm going to make you laugh. I'm going to make you happy, man. Okay. So, yeah, man.
Are you romantic?
Boy, I'd say, yeah, why not? I am. I am a romantic person. Like I said, if I like you, I'm going to make sure that you feel happy, man. I'm going to be romantic. I'm going to be that guy. You know what I'm saying? That I'm meant to be. So there's no harm in being romantic. You didn't come into this world if your mom and dad wasn't being romantic. So you get me? There's no harm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that is true. So what qualities do you look for in a woman?
I'd say a woman who is focused in what she's doing. She's supportive. You know what I'm saying? Encourages, like, probably mean to do more and to do better. Yeah, man, they're always keeping me, like, motivated, really and truly. That's what a woman I'd look for, because, like, in my scene, it's a hard and frustrating scene, you know what I'm saying? So you always need someone behind your back telling you, don't worry, man, it's going to be cool. You got this, man, you know what I'm saying? So that kind of stuff there. Also attractive, looks count, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, that's what I was looking for, educated, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. The simple things, man, the simple things, nothing out of the box too much, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. Yeah. Nice. That sounds pretty good. So should we take it as you are single? What does the future hold for Mr. Silva? I know you've got your upcoming EP. What else? You're just focusing on that.
Yeah, man, just focusing on letting off good music, continuing to do what I'm doing, continue to inspire all my fellow peers and try and lead the scene in the right direction that it needs to go, and trying to just get to the top, man, and where I need to get to, really and truly, just grinding it out and keeping it moving, man, and just trying to achieve great things and make history as I've been doing, man.
Yeah. So, aside from music, what do you do for your community? Because you're from South East London, and you've spoken about how when you go to schools, you like performing there. Like, is there any humanitarian stuff you're involved in or you want to get involved in?
I'm actually an ambassador to a project called City Safe, which is run by the Mayor of London. This project is been set up for, like, children in secondary schools to, like, they create safe havens for, like, their kids. So let's say, like, a kid's getting bullied or a kid's getting robbed or something's going to happen to a kid, like, or they're in danger, they can go to, like, the shop. They have a sticker there called City Safe, like, there. So obviously if they come in, the shopkeeper's not going to be like, get out of my shop. He's going to bring them in and make them feel like they're safe until, like, someone comes along and, you know what I mean, and keeps them cool. And I'm one of the ambassadors, one of the first people to be on that. And yeah, I'm proud to support that project. And yeah, that's what I've been doing outside of the music as well, those charity based events as well, just trying to support the community and give back as well, man, you know what I'm saying? So yeah,
I like that. That's good. So before I let you go, we're definitely going to have to do a little dance. Well, you're going to have to teach me because I have no rhythm to your latest track, Like It, featuring Ames, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah? Let's do this.
If you really want, you can lean on me. I got a something when you be on it. Baby girl said she wanna be lost. She said she really never seen a king like me. Come lean on me, sit on me.
say I'm not true, you go see bumping. With the love of man from a shop of ranking. So in the bedroom, me a top ranking. Say what? Hey, say my hobby, I'm saying. Me di me who I give you. Me di me who I am who. Oh, day. Me my hobby, I'm saying.
I just want to say thank you so much for coming onto this show. Like, not many people can say that they've danced with Mista Silva.
No.
I have. I mean, wasn't that great, but I shake the leg or two with you, so I'm happy about that.
That's good, man. Big shout out to all the fans that are supporting. Make sure you keep supporting. Follow the Twitter, that's MISTAF2DSILVA. Make sure you hit the Instagram, same thing, Mr. Silva, enough Medea, but.
Nice. So don't forget to follow us at The Gist Official. We're going to bring you everything that's trending in entertainment, business, whatever you guys like. Catch you on the next episode.